It's no secret that Pennsylvania has a high number of roads and especially bridges in disrepair, but exactly who's responsible for them and what are they doing about it?
PennDOT is responsible for the safety of approximately 25,000 state-owned highway bridges. Our bridges are probably consumed about 80% of our transportation improvement program.
One look at PennDOT's interactive bridge condition map may give you a fright about crossing one of those bridges. The red dots indicate they are in poor condition.
Upon inspection, if a primary structural element, that being the deck, the superstructure, the substructure, or the culvert itself, has advanced deterioration.
PennDOT says if a bridge fails inspection, it is immediately closed, but more bridges are getting closer to that point. In 2013, the government of the Commonwealth passed Act 89, designed to allocate funds for improvement projects.
Pennsylvania has the nation's second highest gas tax, and a fair chunk of that money should be going towards repairing and upkeep of infrastructure like roads and bridges.
State Representative Mike Carroll is the Democratic chair of the Transportation Committee and says it's not that easy.
Our region's bridges are numerous to start with. We have in District 4, the northeast region of the state, roughly 2,100 bridges in the state system. And then there are additional bridges that are county bridges and local government bridges.
The Keystone State is unique as the burden of PennDOT is greater than in other states.
And because of Pennsylvania's SR system, the four-digit routes, PennDOT has responsibility for over 40,000 miles of road that is far in excess of almost every other state. We have many, many roads that in other jurisdiction would be considered local roads, but in fact are PennDOT's responsibility.
He also says that even with having so much to cover, our area is getting attention.
In our region, we've gone from roughly 6,000 bridges that were in dire need of repair down to about 2,500.
Carroll says it would be more noticeable, but there's an issue. He says funds from transportation are being shifted into paying for state police.
And the dollars that would flow to the state police today would serve our transportation network in a real way when you're talking about $600-700 million annually that we could keep to repair our roads and bridges and support the state police financially from the general fund where that money should come from.
While Pennsylvania is struggling with police funds and departments, Carroll says that would be less of an issue if there were meaningful transportation legislation coming from Capitol Hill.
You hear it with this administration, you've heard it with prior administrations, but the reality is there hasn't been a real transportation bill in the federal government for a long time. And the time has come for our federal partners to support the transportation needs across our region and across our state and nation.
Without much federal aid and some issues to iron out within the state, there is progress.
So we've made improvements, but there are still plenty of bridges that need repair, and many of those bridges are over 50 years old and have really exceeded their capacity with respect to their service life.
In Pittston, Kevin Hayes, Eyewitness News.